Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we are still in chapter 2, but today we continue with freewheeling diet. So what is a freewheeling diet? Okay, a freewheeling diet is actually just a normal diet which has been added here in the half-wave rectifier circuit just to make the output current continuous. Before this, we have learned about half-wave rectifier, right? So if you remember, for the half-wave rectifier, the simplest circuit or the basic circuit of the half-wave rectifier is given by this circuit where we have one diode, one resistive load and an AC source as an input supply. Okay, so with this diode, if you have the input supply like this, okay, the output voltage will be like this, isn't it? Okay, so the output voltage will be same as the input voltage for the first half cycle, but during the negative half cycle, the output is zero for the output voltage. And then what is the output current? Okay, for the output current, the pattern is same like the output voltage, okay? So we have an output current during the positive half cycle, but during the negative half cycle, the output is zero since the voltage is zero. Okay, so this current is actually not continuous, right? So that's why now we added another diode here, okay, to make the current continuous. So how this circuit operates? So to analyze this circuit, as usual, we need to analyze it one by one during the positive half cycle and then during the negative half cycle. Okay, since we have an inductive load here, so this inductor will store the energy during the positive cycle. Okay, and then during the negative half cycle, what will happen to D1 and D2 here? Okay, during the negative half cycle, D2 is forward bias and D1 is reverse bias. So it means that D1 is off, okay, or open circuit, and D2 now is in forward bias or short circuit. Okay, and as the inductor stored the energy before during the positive half cycle, now during the negative half cycle, it will release the stored energy. So it acts like a source now. So this will make this diode D2 forward bias. So it will make D2 forward bias. So current can flow during this negative half cycle. Okay, next for the output waveform, let's say we have an input supply like this. Okay, we have an input supply for one cycle. Okay, so for the output voltage, okay, so this is V in, this is V out, and this is I out. Okay, for V out, let's take a look at the positive half cycle first. So here we have minus V in and then plus V out, right? So using KVL, we know that minus V in plus V out equals to zero. So V in equals to V out. Okay, so this is during the positive half cycle. So input is equal to output. So input is equal to output. So we will get the output voltage like this. Alright, and then during the negative half cycle, so here during the negative half cycle, we have no source here, right? Since it has been disconnected, since the diode is D1 is open circuit. Okay, so V out here is now equals to 0. Okay, so that's why here we will get V output 0 volt. And then for the output current, okay, since we have an inductor here, if you remember, if you have an inductor, so the output current will increase slowly during the positive cycle. Okay, and then during the negative half cycle, this inductor will release the energy. So it will start release the energy. So again, current can still flow. And then this process will repeat again. Okay, so as you can see here, this output current is now is continuous compared to this output current where it is not continuous. Alright, so now you can see the difference between a half-wave rectifier without freewheeling diode and a half-wave rectifier with freewheeling diode. But remember, D1 and D2 cannot be turned on at the same time. So it means that when D1 is on, D2 must be turned off and vice versa. Okay? Okay, next, the load power can be determined using I square RMS. Okay, so we know that, as usual, P equals to I square RMS R, and this IRMS can be determined from the Fourier components of the current, and it is given by using this formula. Okay, so it is the summation of the IN RMS, where the IN is given by VN over ZN. Alright, and the ZN can be determined using R plus JN omega L, or it is equals to R square plus N omega L square, then square root. So using this formula, we can remove this J pipe, imaginary pipe. Okay? And the Fourier series for the voltage across the load can be determined using this formula, where Vn equals to 2 Vm over n square minus 1 times pi. Okay?